لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. Brothers and sisters in Islam, there is a debate between the secular materialistic world and the Muslims regarding the origin, whether it is misguidance or guidance, evil or goodness. Basically, the material world, the secular, the people who promote the evolution, they promote the ideology that mankind was misguided, was evil by birth, and later on he found his way to goodness, like guidance, and he's enlightened now. Basically, they want to confirm their theory that, like, mankind was a chimpanzee at one stage, now he looks good. But the Quran refutes that. قال تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كان الناس أمة واحدة. Mankind used to be one single family, used to be united. And the unifying element, Ibn Abbas mentioned it, كلهم على التوحيد. They were أبن توحيد. Then الأصل is people were أبن توحيد. And then what happened? They went astray. And consequently, the need for messengers and prophets arise to bring the people back to that origin, to that asl. Also, this is obvious in hadith Abi Huraira رضي الله عنه, كل مولود يولد على الفطرة. Every newborn is born a Muslim. الفطرة. فأبواه, then the deviation happens. So the deviation is the incidental, not the origin, like they promote. Also, we have hadith Iyad ibn Himar al-Mujashi'i radiyallahu anhu, al-hadith Qudsi, and half of it is qawl al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, qawl Allah ta'ala. Allah says, إِنِّي خَلَقْتُ عِبَادِي كُلَّهُمْ حُنَفَاءَ. The way that I fashioned my slaves, I made them حنفاء, الحنيف اللي هو على التوحيد. فجاءتهم الشياطين فاجتالتهم. The devils came and took them away from that حنيف path. I think the point that I'm trying to get to here is the question, what are the root causes that led people to go astray from that origin? Alhamdulillah, there is a piece of work I'm working on now, but there is one root cause which is a big problem, and it can lead a lot of people to go astray, which is the over-emphasis on materialism. Basically, the belief in the unseen, whether it doesn't exist at all or whether it's weak, is one of the root causes of misguidance. When you see this world like a box, nothing comes from outside, nor nothing goes up. It's what you see, the material aspect is what you see. It's exactly, and that was issue was raised up in Surah Al-Baqarah, when the children of Israel said to Musa, وَقَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّى نَرَى اللَّهَ جَهْرَةً. We're not going to believe there is a God unless we see God clearly. So they want to see Allah to believe. A big problem. When Muslims are in that area, they will certainly deviate from the truth Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought to them. Why? Because the belief in the unseen opens a lot of gateways to another perspective on a lot of things. At least the way that you look at life. What is life? You see, if you're going to look at everything to be material, then you become a commodity yourself. How much are you worth? You know, it's not about your spiritual presence and the impact you do in humanity. Inshallah, yani, this particular area of the unseen is extremely important. And subhanAllah, when anybody opens the Mus'haf, and of course, the first chapter after Al-Fatiha is Surah Al-Baqarah. Alif Lam Mim. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Look at this. الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. You will find guidance in this book, but with one prerequisite, that you must believe in the unseen. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling anyone who embark on exploring the Quran, if you don't believe in the unseen, don't waste your time. Just go and find something else. Find something better to do with your time. Because if you don't believe in the unseen, you're wasting your time. Because I'm going to talk to you about angels. I'm going to talk to you about nations that existed before you. I'm going to talk to you about the day of judgment, signs of the day of judgment, end of this world, things that will happen on the day of judgment. And you have to believe that. And actually, the level of or the standard of believing in this unseen, of course, there is the unseen that believe in Allah and all of that, but this particular, when it comes to the day of judgment, actually, one of the companions who used to be one of the scribes of the revelation, imagine Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would receive a revelation, and then he would call him if he's present to ask him to write the verse that was, or the verses, group of verses that were just revealed. His name is Hanzala al-Usaydi. وهذا يعني also غسيل الملائكة. Hanzala هذا غسيل الملائكة. Angels washed him. The story very brief. He got married. The night of the wedding, in the morning, حي على الجهاد. He left his wife without taking his ghusl. So he was killed in the battle. The Prophet said, angels are washing this. Ask his wife. And she confirmed that. One day he came to Abu Bakr and he said, نفق حنظلة. I'm a hypocrite. Imagine he accuses himself of hypocrisy. Abu Bakr asked him, why are you saying that? He said, when we are sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he would talk to us about Jannah and hell, look at this, فَكَأَنَّ نراها رأي عين, as if we see it. But when we go back home, we mingle with the wife, with the children, with the business. So that faith or that certainty, اليقين هذا, downsize, goes down. It's not like... فأبو بكر said, then I'm a hypocrite like you because I feel the same way. So both of them went to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and they presented the case to him. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to them, this is your test basically, because Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, ya ikhwa, we believe Iman goes up and down. Iman goes up and down. When you engage in a gathering like this, your Iman gradually goes up and you're going to feel it by the end of the khutbah. You're just going to feel it. But when you go and engage in other activities that are not faith related, especially if they are dunya related, you find out your Iman is dropping, is it goes down. For the Prophet said to them, that's what you have to struggle with, because you can't just be around me all the time. You have to take care of your livelihood, but make sure that you don't stay absent from this. Inshallah, acting upon this, let's remind ourselves, and inshallah I will embark today, this Jum'ah and the Jum'ahs to come whenever I'm in town, yani, inshallah, talking about the Day of Judgment, scenes from the Day of Judgment. And just to show you how much information we have about this day that you actually can sit and visualize, like the Sahaba. You sit and visualize, and this is what they used to do. And I shared this with you before. A predecessor by the name of Muhammad ibn Wasa, I believe, he was sitting in a group of his company. He's a predecessor, he's not a Sahabi. They noticed that he's silent and he's having this deep thinking, you know. He's silent and thinking deep. What are you? You know, when somebody is sitting with you, but he said, I am on the bridge, ala sirat. I'm walking over hill on the bridge. I'm visualizing it. Visualizing the grave. Have you ever imagined? Have you ever visualized yourself in the grave? That generation also used to dig a grave in his house, and he would go and sleep in it, just to get the feeling of it. Because one day we're going to have to face that. Let me begin. I was going to talk about resurrection. I hope time will allow me. But I really want to give you a map quest of how this world will end. And I promise you, anything that I say today, because I don't want to be thinking much about the evidence, I'm sure it comes from the Quran or the Sunnah. Because, ikhwah, nobody can talk about stuff like that without an evidence. Otherwise, he is whether crazy or ignorant, one of the two. Because هذا غيب, this is unseen. How are you going to say something that's not validated by evidence? Obviously, brothers and sisters in Islam, right now we're living the final phases of the minor signs of the Day of Judgment. Scholars categorize the Day of Judgment, the signs of the Day of Judgment. You know, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you signs that you're about to die, like sickness, gray hair, you know, one of your family member dying. Also, Allah placed some signs for you that can indicate that this world is about to end, which the scholars broke down into categories. They said minor and major. And also they divided the minor signs into signs that happened and will never happen again. Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a sign of the hour. That sign will never be repeated. But they also given another category. They said there are signs that begin, but as the time goes by, they grow. Like adultery had a start, Now adultery is all over the place. Immorality is all over the place. Killing is all over, earthquakes. So the magnitude increases as you approach the end of the world, the end of this world. So there are a couple of signs that are left from the minor signs. One of them is the Euphrates in Iraq. Discloses a mountain of gold that people will kill one another for it. But the famous sign that is left is the emergence or the emerging of someone who will unite the Muslims again. The Imam, his name is Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Mahdi, according to Ahlul Sunnah. Be careful, because the Shia has a sci-fi concept that really unfound, that someone went into a tunnel and he's hiding there, and one day he will come out. We don't believe that stuff. This is, you know, this is a Dajjal, actually, if you reflect upon it. This is a Dajjal, is the one who's chained somewhere. But Shahid, this Imam, who is from the offspring of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, will unite the Muslims. And this, in a way, will lead to a Dajjal coming out, because a Dajjal, Allah will let a Dajjal out. And this will lead to Isa coming down, Prophet Isa alayhi salam, his second coming, to kill a Dajjal, to kill the Antichrist, and also to handle the most corrupt of the offspring of Adam, the two tribes, Gog and Magog, Ya'juj and Ma'juj. But then after that, the world will go through a break, interval, like really a time that you wish to live that time. That is when Isa actually becomes the leader of the Muslim world, ruling from Jerusalem. There will be peace. And that's where they say the wolf will play with the sheep, and the children will play with the snakes. Even that, you'll find that even in the book of Revelation and in the Christian tradition, the biblical tradition, you will find it there. But there will be a time of peace until Prophet Isa dies, he is buried. Then people gradually will leave the religion again. And these minor signs which we are living now will reintroduce themselves again. Again, the ones that could reoccur, like adultery, will come back again. So is another phase of these minor signs. But this time, it will lead to the other set of the major signs, which really, no way back. Khalas, it's over. And that will be initiated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending a beast, an animal, who will actually speak to the people. وَإِذَا وَقَعَ الْقَوْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ, هذا في القرآن سورة النمل, أَخْرَجْنَا لَهُمْ دَابَّةً مِنَ الْأَرْضِ تُكَلِّمُهُمْ أَنَّ النَّاسَ كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا لَا يُوقِنُونَ. This beast actually will brand the people. This is kafir, this is Muslim. Then the famous, the sun rising from the west, the sun will rise. One day people will wake up in the morning and they will see the sun rising from the west, not from the east. And that is when the gates of Tawbah, no more. وذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ذكر, he mentioned في صحيح الإمام مسلم حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, ثلاث إذا خرجنا لا ينفع نفسا إيمانها لم تكن آمنت من قبل أو كسبت في إيمانها خيرا. There are three signs. If they come out, faith is not going to benefit you. And he named them الدجال, الدابة, وطلوع الشمس من مغربها. Those three. So you have to actually be a believer before that. الشاهد, I'm running through this quickly. After that, subhanAllah, إخوة, and that shows you death is actually something good. You see, you know, a lot of people, and but again, only if you believe in the hereafter, only if you believe in the unseen, your look or perception towards death will change. Look at this hadith, hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu anhuma, that Allah will send a soft wind which will find every believer on the face of this earth and suffocate him. Die. Rihun tayyiba. It's actually called the good wind. Good wind. So this good wind, even if they run away, by the way, to the mountains, it will follow them. Why? وَلَا يَبْقَى عَلَى الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا شِرَارُ النَّاسِ وَعَلَيْهِمْ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةِ. The worst of the children of Adam are the ones who will be on the face of this earth when the day of judgment takes place. So the good people are, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned a couple of things that they would actually go back and worship idols. They will commit adultery on the open like the animals. They will sleep with one another like in the animals, like in the street, like that. Nobody goes to Hajj and Umrah. That is why there is a guy from Abyssinia, the Suwayqataini, his name, his feet are like a bow, like boo, it's called that. He's going to come and take down the Kaaba. Nobody cares. Nobody cares, no, because nobody performs Hajj and Umrah anyways. So he will go and take down the Kaaba. The worst of mankind. Something, Ikhwa, that really amazes you, when Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam given description of those people on whom the hour will take place, he did not exempt himself from that. Really something that really يعني amazes you. And I'm referring to hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri رضي الله عنه والحديث في مسند أحمد والحاكم في المستدرك. The Prophet says, كيف أنعم وقد التقم صاحب القرن القرن وأحنى جبهته وأصغى سمعه ينتظر متى ينفخ في الصور. How can I feel at ease, يعني enjoy life, when there is an angel out there who's holding something in his mouth called البوق, like the trumpet, يعني, but the size is different, something that he will blow in it. And this angel, actually, look at his position. His head is to the throne. أَحْنَا جَبْهَتَ. He's looking like this. He doesn't blink at all. No blinking at all. His ears waiting for Allah to tell him what? Now. Now. How can I feel at ease? Because this could happen at any time. Now, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands this angel to blow in that trumpet, that means everyone on the face of this earth will die, because there are living people, and like I said, they have nothing to do with Islam. They are all kuffar. So all of those will die, will go to death. وفي debate, there is a debate, يا إخوة, whether it will be one blow or two. بمجموع الآيتين, there are two verses. One of them is في سورة النمل and the other in سورة الزمر. The verse is in سورة النمل, ونفخ في الصور فصعق من في السماوات ومن في الأرض إلا من شاء الله ثم نفخ فيه أخرى فإذا هم قيام ينظرون في الزمر. So a lot of the scholars يعني reconciled that, and they said the first blow will terrorize people and then it will cause them to die. But the second blow is, that's when they come back up for resurrection. But this is how this world will end, ya ikhwa. You know, that's the scenario that, and I'm telling you, you know, every single word I quoted, and correct me if I'm wrong, is not my words. This is all supported by evidence. So you have that scenario. The point I'm trying to make here is you have that scenario. You have, you're able to do like the Sahabi, to visualize that, to live that, to think about this. Where will you be? You know, the question now, where you, will you be when, for example, Jesus comes, when the Dajjal comes out, when Ya'juj, are you going to be there or not? And all of this. But here is more importantly, the hereafter. Brothers and sisters in Islam, what will happen in between those two blows in the trumpet, in the sur, which one of them will cause mankind, the world, to collapse? Imagine this beautiful world that we're fighting for, people killing one another for it, will, you know, dismantle. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi hadith Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu anhuma, he says, من أراد أن ينظر إلى الساعة. If you want to visualize what will happen when the day of judgment is here, read the beginning of these three chapters. إذا الشمس كورت وإذا النجوم انكدرت إذا السماء انشقت وإذا السماء انفطرت. Those three. I'll give you a picture. Imagine that sun will come down, will be shrouded. The moon down. Break. إن يوم الفصل كان ميقاتا يوم ينفخ في الصور فتأتون أفواجا وفتحت السماء فكانت أبوابا وسيرت الجبال فكانت سرابا وترى الجبال. You see these beautiful mountains that you see in color. وترى الجبال تحسبها جامدة وهي تمر مر السحاب. It will walk in front of you like cloud. صنع الله. صنع الله. Out of this world, the dismantling of this universe, the death of people. What will happen in between? Hadith Abi Huraira, radiallahu anhu, wal hadith akhrajahu al-imam al-Bukhari wa Muslim. He said, بَيْنَ النَّفْخَتَيْنِ أَرْبَعُونَ. Between the two blows in the trumpet. You see, the first one now, for you to follow me, the first one is everyone is dead, will cause people, everyone, to die. Now there will be 40. He said that between the two blows, there will be 40. So the companions asked him, أربعون what? 40 what? 40 days. قال أبيت. He said, I didn't ask. We know that at one stage, the Sahaba are banned from asking questions. Or أبيت أن أجزم. Or I am in no position to dictate that. I don't know. أربعون شهرا أربعون سنة أبيت أبيت أبيت. But in between this, subhanallah, ikhwa, Allah will send a rain which will contact a tailbone, which is in the back here. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam referred to it في الحديث كل ابن آدم يبلى إلا عجب الذنب. All the children of Adam body, the bones, the flesh, the teeth, earth will eat it, will be consumed by earth, except a very tiny tailbone called عجب الذنب. منها يركب. Subhanallah, when this rain contacts, they call it DNA, whatever you want to call it, then your body will begin growing. A new body, by the way. You're going to have a new body, but it's you. It's you, and you will be recognized. But it's a new body, not that body that you have. Why do you need a new body? Because the day of judgment is 50,000 years long. Think about this number, 50,000, one day. You're going to have to stand up on this day, no food, no water, People will be drowning. Certain people will be drowning on their sweat. But they will not die. وَيَأْتِيهِ الْمَوْتُ مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ وَمَا هُوَ بِمَيِّتٍ Like the things that you would face in this world would cause you to die. But these, you're going to be able to see the angels, the jinn. And of course, if Allah wills, you will see Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala on the land of gathering. Because certain people will be prevented from that. كَلَّا إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ Certain people are like that. But before I go there, really one of the most fascinating things, ikhwa, that the Day of Judgment, when you study it, the names of Allah become manifest. And subhanAllah, when I always read this verse, اللي هي في سورة الفرقان اللي هو إيه وقال الذين لا يرجون لقاءنا لولا أنزل علينا الملائكة أو نرى ربنا لقد استكبروا في أنفسهم وعتوا عتوا كبيرا لا الملك يومئذ الحق للرحمن kingship on that day of judgment will be for Allah well Allah is the king now Allah owns everything now But you see, a lot of us are not seeing that. We are preoccupied by this world, thinking that this guy is a king, this guy is rich, this guy is a president. So we forget who is what. On the day of judgment, this will become manifest. And if you want to see this, read the verses in chapter Ghafir. يَوْمَهُمْ بَارِزُونَ لا يخفى على الله منهم شيء الله actually سبحانه وتعالى الله سبحانه وتعالى will ask this question when everyone is dead لمن الملك اليوم everybody is dead who's the king today who nobody answers him actually he will answer himself سبحانه وتعالى لله الواحد القهار Everything belongs to me now. Everything. You see the name of Allah, Al-Malik, 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 three names. Malik, Malik, Malik. وفي wording of this hadith, hadith Abdullah ibn Mas'ud في الصحيحين, a Jewish rabbi came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا محمد, he said, Muhammad, إن صلى الله عليه وسلم إنا نقرأ في التوراة We read in the Torah في كتبنا إذا كان يوم القيامة On the day of judgment Allah سبحانه وتعالى will place the entire seven heavens in one of his fingers Now don't visualize them Don't Allah has fingers How they look I don't know But they are not like yours ليس كمثله شيء And if shaitan plays with your head, get you to visualize his fingers in a certain way, say subhanallah, Allah is above that. كُلُّ مَا دَارَ بِبَالِكَ فَاللَّهُ بِخِلَافِ ذَلِكَ هَوَا الْمَنْهَجَهُ منهج واضح بين clear methodology in dealing with the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah didn't ask you to figure out how his fingers are. لَمْ يَتَعَبَّدَكَ اللَّهُ بِالْكَيْفِيَّةِ بعدين at the end of the day لا يعلم كيف الله إلا الله only Allah knows how Allah is so Allah will have the seven heavens there are seven of them on one finger the seven earth there are seven earth by the way too not planets not continents like some waqus say لا seven earth الله الذي خلق سبع سماوات ومن الأرض مثلهن Then Allah will place the trees in one finger the water and الثرى I don't know what الثرى is maybe the vegetation on one finger and the rest of the creation in one finger and He will shake them He will shake them the entire creation on his hand He will shake them and he will say, أنا الملك. I am the king. أين ملوك الأرض? Where are those who used to call themselves kings in this world? Highness, your highness, king of Jordan, king of Morocco, king, whatever is it? King, king, king. Where are you? أين الجبارون? This is the statement of who? Of the Jew, the Jewish individual, the rabbi, the prophet. ضحك, he smiled, حتى بدت نواجذه. To the extent that you could see his molar teeth. This is what they call molar teeth. This teeth here. Molar teeth. Then he recited the verses in Surah Az-Zumar confirming what the Jewish rabbi is saying. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامِ. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعلى من اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when we are beneath earth, like the hadith of Abi Huraira, every piece of us will be consumed by earth. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كل ابن آدم يبلى إلا عجب الذنب. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would send a rain which will go down into earth, contacting that tailbone. It's called ajbud dhanab. It's a very end of the bone in the back. And subhanAllah, your body will begin growing beneath earth. Like I said, a new body, which will begin growing beneath earth. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would command Israfil again to blow in the trumpet. ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَإِذَا هُمْ. Earth will split open and then will come. SubhanAllah, wallahi, seen out of this world. Out of this world. Yeah. We show how the Quran, many places in the Quran, take Qaf. وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ هُمْ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ بَطْشًا فَنَقَّبُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ فَاصْبِرْ عَلَمَا واستمع يوم ينادي المنادي من مكان قريب يوم يسمعون الصيحة بالحق. You will hear that blow in the trumpet. ذلك يوم الخروج. This is the day when you will come from beneath earth. يوم تشقق الأرض عنهم سراعا. Earth will open like this. ذلك حشر علينا يسير اقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر وإن يروا آية يعرضوا. Earthquake, يعرضوا ويقولوا سحر مستمر وكذبوا واتبعوا أهواءهم وكل أمر مستقر ولقد جاءهم من الأنباء ما فيه مزدجر حكمة بالغة فما تغني النذر فتول عنهم. يوم يدعو الداعي إلى شيء نكر خشعا أبصارهم. They will come like this. يخرجون من الأجداث أي من القبور كأنهم جراد منتشر مهطعين إلى الداع. يقول الكافرون هذا يوم عسر. والله the Quran illustrates this in a way out of this world. Out of this world. طيب, I'm here to scare you. No. One lesson. One lesson. I'm going to share with you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned in an authentic hadith that you will rise from beneath the ground doing what you died doing. One lesson, just one lesson. يبعث كل مرء على ما مات عليه. So if you died listening to music, playing video games, drinking, you will come on the day of judgment. وفي حديث عبد الله بن عباس, on the day of عرفة, a man wearing his ihram, رفسته دابته, his animal, mule, knocked him dead. The Prophet said to him, what? Bury him in his shroud. Bury him in his ihram. فإنه يبعث يوم القيامة ملبية. Imagine that. Someone comes in the day of judgment, wearing the ihram. لبيك اللهم لبيك. The other one will come dancing, smoking, drinking. How you want to be raised up? That's one lesson, just one lesson from this, from the entire thing. Inshallah, we'll continue for the sake of time. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم وفقنا إلى ما تحب وترضى وخذ بنواصينا إلى البر والتقوى. اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهديين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم.